Before I start, I would like to show you my hair. If you see it from far, you could see the, do you guys see the gaps? You're not supposed to have gaps in your hair. And then the part that gets me the most is right here. You could see into my scalp. See? Even parting my hair to the side isn't working anymore. Okay. So I noticed that my hair, I was losing hair about a year ago. And immediately I started researching what I could do to get my hair back. And I spent a bunch of money on shampoos and on oils. I googled everything. I tried nettle tea. I tried castor oil. I tried shampoos. I even tried onion, and all that did was make my hair smell bad. Like, my hair got a little thicker, but at the end of the day, my hair kept falling out. So then I went to the doctor, which is what I should have done at the beginning, and I recommend you guys do the same, because it could be something that's going on inside your body, that whatever you put to the scalp won't do anything because inside your body. So I went and they took my blood, and I had low thyroid and high testosterone. He recommended me to go to an endocrinologist, and I did. And then they took my blood and they said I had elevated DHEA, high testosterone, and my low thyroid improved. So that's a good thing. So I started researching about elevated DHEA, and I ran into this lady's story. She said that she was taking birth control for a really long time, and that birth control was causing her hair loss. And so she started eating healthy, she did a bunch of life changes, exercising, and she said her hair grew back. I'm gonna put her story down below. But then after I read that story, I was like, okay, I've never taken birth control, but what I have taken is Plan B. And at that time I took about 8 Plan B's, you know, not all in once, obviously, throughout the, you get me. And one of the possible side effects of Plan B is hair loss. And Plan B completely messed up my hormones. If I could go back, I would have never taken Plan B, and I would have stuck to condoms. And this lady, her problem was with birth control. Let me tell you guys that there's some birth controls that reduce androgens, some birth control low in androgens, and some birth controls high in androgens. Talk to your doctor to eliminate the one with high androgens, because that could be the cause of your hair loss. And Plan B completely messed up my hormones. Something the lady said on her story was that this was an awakening for her. And before I read that, I was thinking, this is an awakening for me. I need to treat my body right. I need to eat healthy. I need to, you know, exercise. And so I'm going to take the route she took. I don't want to take anti-androgen birth control like my doctor recommended. What I want to do is I want to eat healthy. I want to put inside my body good things. I believe that food is medicine, that everything we need to get better is all around us. And you know, obviously not for everything, okay, but for this, I believe that I could balance my hormones naturally. That is my goal. And I'll put her link below, and if you get anything out of this video, I want you guys to take these three things. Number one, if you're experiencing hair loss, don't waste your money on a bunch of products and oils. Don't buy Rogaine. Go to your doctor first. Go to your doctor first and tell him your symptoms. Tell him what you've been experiencing. Make sure he checks your testosterone and your thyroid. And I think they'll do the DHEA in the endocrinologist if they send you there. And so number one, go to your doctor, ladies. That money that you could be spending on products, you could be spending on the doctor, okay? Number two, stay away from Plan B and birth control with high androgens. Just avoid it. Number three, treat your body right, because what you put inside will show outwardly.